Warning, hydrogen peroxide and oxalyl chloride are corrosive. Wear gloves when handling them. Oxalyl chloride is a toxic lacrimator. Work outside in a fume hood. Greetings fellow nerds. Most glow sticks are activated by liquid, usually hydrogen peroxide. In this video we're going to make one activated by vapor. First we're going to start with our solvent. Around 3 milliliters of dimethyl phthalate. Now we add in a fluorescent dye. I'm using 3 milligrams of rubrene. This will give us a yellow color. You can also use 9-10 bisphenylethylanthracene for a green color, or 9-10 diphenylanthracene for blue. Once that's all shaken up, we then add an equal volume of 30% hydrogen peroxide. Now give that a shake to dissolve as much of the hydrogen peroxide as possible. Now give it a few minutes to settle. The hydrogen peroxide layer will float on top of the denser dimethyl phthalate layer. Now we pipette out the bottom dimethyl phthalate layer and apply it to a surface like this logo card. Now for the key ingredient, oxalyl chloride. This stuff is quite volatile and you'll need to work with it in a fume hood. We're going to use the vapors from this oxalyl chloride to create chemiluminescence. Now turn off the lights and hold the card near the cap of the bottle and open it. Whoa! I just cracked open the bottle and the burst of oxalyl chloride vapor activated the glow. Interestingly enough, the solution is on my gloves and I'm coloring everything I touch. It's amazingly beautiful the waves of brightness that wash over the card since the cloud of vapor isn't uniform. So what's happening? When the oxalyl chloride vapor hits the solution, it instantly reacts with the hydrogen peroxide to form dioxetane ione. This in turn reacts with fluorescent dye to release light. This reaction also works in liquid solution, but I want to demonstrate the vapor reaction since it looks so much cooler. Okay, I've repeated the same experiment, but this time I'm using 9-10 bisphenylethylanthracene for a green color. Let me set it up, opening the cap, and there we go. That is awesome. You might be wondering if this is used in glow sticks. It's not, because it only lasts for a few seconds before breaking down. So oxalyl chloride is converted into longer lasting chemicals like TCPO, which can last hours. It's really unfortunate that oxalyl chloride is a toxic lacrimator. Inhaling it is very dangerous. I could see this effect being an awesome magic trick or even a practical effect for videos. You can pretend you're casting spells or something. But as it is, this YouTube video will probably be the closest most people will encounter this. Safely anyway. Oh cool. The solution actually soaked all the way through the card so it even works through the back. Okay, now I'm going to do another dye, 9-10 diphenylanthracene. Simply sublime. I'm sorry I don't have any red, these are all the colors I have on hand. Oh by the way, if you're interested in more videos on chemiluminescence, you can check out a few others that I've made in the video description. Here are all the cards I've made, and let's see if we can get them all to glow. I'm trying to pour the vapor onto the cards. Looks like I got some cross-contamination since the chemicals spewed onto my glove. We have some green on the yellow card and a few spots of yellow in the blue card. Let me see if I can hit the airstream of my fume hood and get the vapors to cover all the cards. And there you have it. Vapor activate chemiluminescence. Thanks for watching. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.